Good morning, everyone, excellencies, friends, colleagues. What can I say after the eloquent speech of Dr. Tariq and Dr. Rashid? They've summed it all, and really it's very difficult to live up to the standards which they have set. Having said this, I will try my best to just get you interested in what we all are professing. I've never felt more at home than when I talk to Dr. Rashid, because he really makes a difference in everything we are doing. I would like to show my age and talk about something else. Sharjah has always been pioneer emirate in everything. The first really modern power plant was built Leia and Sharjah. The first real development in desalination and the MED system was really, would have never progressed so far without the help of the SIWA. Our experiments on a lot of things have always been done with SIWA throughout the years. So thank you very much, Sharjah. Thank you, SIWA. And thank you, Dr. Rashid, for breathing back the life into this wonderful organization. My table of contents for today are the water and power. I will do an introduction, which already have been really covered very adequately by both Dr. Tariq and Dr. Rashid. I'm going to talk about the challenges, and I'm going to talk about the opportunities, and hopefully I'll talk about the takeaway from this introduction. The rise in GDP and the rise in the standard of living, if you like, of everybody on this world has created, and the rise of population has created conditions which are not sustainable. And that's precisely how Dr. Tariq has talked about. We cannot continue. Business as usual is not an option. Because of a lot of things, we can talk about greenhouse effects, we can talk about climate change, we are all going through this. And I will say even something which I've witnessed myself. When I lived in the UAE in the 70s, goodness, the weather was totally different. It's a different country as far as I'm concerned now. The second thing, the rise in mega cities is really just phenomenal. And this is something which has to be addressed, and we need to see what can be done to address this issue. If you look at cities like Mexico, look at cities like Rio, look at these kind of big population centers, it needs some action, and we cannot just ignore it. It needs some action for a lot of things. We cannot just let centers, which like you see in Rio, I don't know how many had the chance to go and visit Rio de Janeiro. There are areas of town where you cannot even approach. People live in a different world. The risks, social cohesion, inequalities. I was talking about New Mexico, about Mexico City. I'm talking even New Delhi has the same thing. A lot of these cities cannot continue as they are.